Let's wander. Today, Lila and Buddy are with me. And we are out on the day tripper. And at the moment, we've pulled over at Riker's car park by Box Hill. And we're just out on the road trip today. We're not sure where we're going to go. We're just following the road and see where it takes us. So, this is a real wander, because we are wandering. With all this being said, let's hit the road, let's wander. Okay, so we've pulled over on the A29, Staines Street, in a town called Ockley. Now, I've always wanted to pull over here and have a look around, and you'll see why in a minute. It's an amazing looking place. Let's go and have a look. Ockley is a village in southern England that you may never have heard of. It has the appearance of the ideal English village. Ockley has a village pond frequented by its own angling society. And it has a cricket club. However, in 851 it was a battleground as King Ethelwulf and his son Ethelbald and the West Saxon army fought off an invading Danish army that had seen its way through Canterbury and London. It's beer in that.
I want a drink.
This is Scott's Well. It was put in place as a request from Jane Scott, who was governess at Ellerslie until she passed away from consumption on the 9th of March, 1808. Another part of her legacy is the local school. The houses around the green are stunning and date back centuries. We headed back to the day tripper and once on the A29 headed further south. We passed by Paulborough as we could not find anywhere to pull up. The car park was full, so we headed towards Bignor Hill. Bignor Hill is my favourite place in the South Downs. On a clear day, views stretch for miles and miles. Because it is mainly frequented by hikers and all-terrain cyclists, Bignor Hill is a peaceful place where you can get some space away from other people. You often hear the song of skylarks as you pass by the crops. Skylarks are a ground nesting bird, so keep your dog under control and out of the crops. Over the brow of the hill you come to a mountain block which was a memorial to George Toby Wentworth Fitzwilliam. Toby was the illegitimate son of Earl George Charles Wentworth Fitzwilliam and Daisy Evelyn Lister. Toby's parents, George and Daisy, were married in Scotland by mutual exchange and consent. This marriage stood as valid under Scottish law. George and Daisy had a small ceremony in London 2 years later for legality. 7 months earlier, Daisy had given birth to a son. Here he lies where he longed to be. Home is the sailor, home from the sea, and the hunter, home from the hill. Okay, that brings us to the end of our road trip for today. As I said, we ended up at Bignor Hill, which is really nice because it's one of my favourite places to be. I needed to get away and really clear my mind, if you know what I mean. And it's also Lila's birthday today. It's the 19th of March, and she is 10 years old. So I'm going to say happy birthday to a rather tired out Lila. And tired out Buddy as well down there. We're going to get back home. So with all this being said, we'll see you again soon. Bye, 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 bye.